Do you love and hate WordPress at the same time? Are you thinking about replacing your WordPress site with a custom platform or CMS, but you're afraid that it's a ton of work and neither have the time nor have the budget? Why not make it headless? Or at least look into the other headless solutions out there. But what is even a headless CMS? Do you need to hire a warrior with a big sword to make it headless and rip the head off? Well, sort of. Is a headless CMS better than WordPress or a custom CMS? Let's see the two sides of this debate. So, first thing first, what is a headless CMS? The head in the headless CMS refers to the frontend. You get rid of the head and just use the backend to store your content, and an API to deliver it. Then you will have a content as a system or CaaS. That means your content storage and delivery are handled by separate software. A headless CMS does not care about how and where your content gets displayed. A headless CMS has only one focus, storing and delivering structured content. But why exactly is it needed? It seems like a bloody option. Because you can keep the things you love about your WordPress or any other CMS that you're using and just create the extra needed features without reinventing the wheel. It can save you precious dev time and subsequently costs. But let's go deeper than that, while the head is still warm. Did you ever wanted to use modern dev tools like Node.js, React, and server-side rendering? By losing the head, you can integrate with any codebase and use your preferred language. Because there is no tight coupling between business applications and CMS, resulting in flexibility that allows you to choose whatever technology and framework you like for your application. You can fetch the content via REST or even GraphQL services. It's all up to you. Another major benefit of using headless CMS is that the same content can be published to a website, an app, or anything connected to the Internet of Things. You can even connect it to an AI-powered device. The possibilities of headless are endless. You can use it with any head that you want. You can achieve faster time to market with a headless solution. From a technical standpoint, headless CMS simply uses API calls to render content within the website's codebase, rather than creating complex relationships between code and content. For this reason, many developers find headless architecture easier to maintain, deploy, and use. It can nicely fit into the microservice-based solution landscape. One of the main reasons for choosing a headless solution is because of performance and security. With a traditional CMS, most of the times you have to use a lot of plugins to achieve a desired output in your frontend. And after a while, these plugins slow you down or create security holes in your system. If we can replace them with custom codes, you can achieve higher page speed, lower resource usage, and tighten the grip on the security. Sometimes you just install a tiny plugin for an email subscription widget, and next day your website is completely hijacked. The most popular CMSs in the world right now has a horrendous history in terms of security. Well, they say that your WordPress is as secure as your least secure plugin or theme. And it's a sad yet true fact. How much time do your developers need in order to implement a simple form in their favorite programming language, without the hassles of creating a plugin, because they simply do not need to do that. If you can lower your resource usage, you can become more scalable. Keeping the backend and frontend separated usually means no downtime is needed for maintenance. So you can upgrade and customize your website without compromising performance. With Headless, you can hide your backend and go stealth. No one needs to know your login URL or your API endpoints. They can live on two separate servers or virtual machines. This enables the administrator to rest assured that the system is secure and protected against the millions of anonymous attacks happening each and every day. There are even some websites offering Headless CMS as a service. Another benefit of Headless is easier integration of other systems like the shopping cart or a product information system. It also means that it's far easier to integrate new technologies when they emerge without breaking the rest of your system. How can you make your WordPress, Joomla, or Drupal headless? As long as your CMS comes with an API for fetching contents, you can host it anywhere that you want and use the API to access your contents. It doesn't matter where you even host it, on a subdomain, a subfolder, or even an IP address. You just need to log in the backend and input the content. The API integration between the backend and the frontend can do the rest. And yes, the REST API is a perfect choice. WordPress has a REST API out of the box. Drupal comes packaged with a RESTful Web Services module. So, in most cases, you don't need to worry about the API. You can even install and use some plugins to have the extra flexibility in the backend. Are there content management systems that are headless by default? Yes, absolutely. And they are becoming a thing nowadays. Neither WordPress nor Drupal were built with the purpose of being headless. So you may be better off learning from an open source option. Here are some of the big players. If you need a self-hosted headless CMS, you can use Strapi.js, DirectX, CraftCMS, or .cms. If you are looking for a headless CMS as a service, you can use Zesty.io, Contentful, GraphCMS, DotaCMS, or Storyblock. Or you can just Google it. There are a ton of good reviews out there. What are the challenges of using a headless CMS? Traditional CMS architectures are ideal for blogs, personal sites, and very basic company websites, because everything is all together. It is easy to develop, manage, and publish tech-specs content quickly. Design is also simplified within a traditional CMS, with built-in themes and templates, and a frontend that can be edited and customized as needed. Headless platforms lack web delivery layers like templating systems. Unlike traditional CMS architecture, which requires you to follow specific rules and use designated programming languages, headless CMS gives developers complete control over how content is presented to the user. So, that means that you cannot buy a template or a plugin running Vue to market and kickstart your site. You need to hire a developer most of the times and stick to the other template formats like HTML. Headless CMS may also present formatting challenges, since you can always preview the content and get to know how it feels. Therefore, you have to take extra measures to anticipate how things will turn out on the frontend. You can put more codes in the frontend to show this draft content to only a specific user. While using headless architecture comes with some security advantages, you will have to set up permissions and user credentials to protect confidential content from non-authorized users, which can be tedious. Headless CMS can impose high costs if not done in the right manner and also loss of functionality. Ultimately, each organization has different requirements and would need to evaluate the strategy of using a headless CMS, because decoupling your CMS is something you should seriously consider. What are the use cases for a headless CMS? While a traditional coupled CMS architecture is great for simpler sites, it's not an ideal choice for those that are more complex. Headless CMS can be an ideal choice for the following use cases. When your website and app are utilizing JavaScript frameworks like React.js, Vue.js, or Angular, or if you want to use server-side rendering in your project. If you are going to publish your content across multiple delivery platforms. If you are going to deliver content to an iOS or Android app from the same backend. If the user base is growing fast and you want to reduce your server costs. If you want to enrich product information on e-commerce sites. If you are going to create a custom platform for your business and you don't want to create a CMS part from the ground up, but a traditional CMS is going to impose too much rigidity onto your project. So, what is the conclusion? Do you really need headless? It really depends on your requirements. Using a headless CMS isn't the best option for every web project, but you should at least familiarize yourself with the concept, since they are becoming more and more popular in the content management ecosystem. Headless CMS is here to stay, and will likely be the shape of things to come in the future. The headless CMS concept is one born from the demands of the digital era and a business's need to focus on engaging customers with personalized content via multiple channels at all stages of the customer journey. Headless CMS architecture is a great solution to robust your team of developers and can help you publish dynamic and innovative content to any type of platform or device connected via IoT. WordPress, WooCommerce, Joomla, Shopify, Squarespace. Who else is on your list for beheading? If it is Sir Gregor, you might need to be more careful. That's it for now. Let us your opinion in the comments. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe for more tech debates like this one.